Right, everyone. Okay. Okay, let's start. So we already discussed about the budgetary expenditure, right? Revenue and all that. So today we will be doing with the revenue part first. Okay. So let's just start. So the other thing, first thing which we need to learn about over here is, like, for example, you have the, I'm just explaining it over here. It's the expenditure, right? When you, wait. When you are doing expenditure, right, you have two things with you. One is your asset and one is your liability. Yes. So when you are doing expenditure, what will happen? Your asset will increase. Yes or no? Earlier, for example, you have one car. Now you did expenditure. Now you have two cars, right? And what about your liability? Your liability will decrease. Why? Because earlier you had 100 crore of loan. Now you repaid it. You did expenditure. Now your liability decreased. These are the two scenarios. Yes or no? Right? So because of this, what will happen? Right? Either you will bring something at your place which will increase your asset, or you will repay all the loans, whatever borrowing you have done, and that will automatically decrease your liability. Right? So now let's just understand about the scenario. So revenue expenditure is, these expenditure do not create assets. So for example, expenditure, what you did basically, like the scholarship, you are the government and you get scholarship to the students. Will it increase your asset and decrease your liability? No, ma'am, because scholarship is something which will not be a part of this, right? So revenue expenditure are those expenditure which do not create asset for the government, right? Plus, there is no cause and reduction in the liability. Clear? Example, expenditure on old age pension, employment allowance, scholarship, salary, subsidies, and all that. But capital expenditure are those expenditure which will create asset for you. For example, you constructed a building. You purchased some share. So constructed a building. Earlier, you have only one building. Now you constructed one more. Right? These cause reduction in the liability of the government. Right? Repayment of loan. Right? These expenditure are recurring in nature. This year you gave scholarship. Next year also you will give scholarship, right? They are non-recurring. Once you constructed the home, done, right? Assets and liability of the government are not affected, but assets and liability of the government are affected over here. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you will write difference between revenue expenditure and capital expenditure. Okay, girls done. Everyone done? Both of you? Okay, now let's just move to the next one. This is development expenditure and non-development expenditure, right? Development means, for example, you are doing something. Development expenditure directly contribute to the flow of goods and services, right? Whether the goods will be produced or the services you will do. Non-development expenditure indirectly contribute to the goods flow of goods and services. So over here, it's productive in nature. It adds to the flow of goods and services. This is non-productive in nature, right? So expenditure on development of agriculture sector, industries and transport, and expenditure and administration. Like for example, this is my office, the maintenance fees which I am doing expenditure. This is not adding any goods and services, right? Defense and justice. So this is what, okay?
Done, ma'am.
Okay, both of you done?
Yes, ma'am, done.
Okay, now moving to next one, plan expenditure and non-plan expenditure. So plan is basically, for example, I'm planning that this year I will produce more electricity. I will produce more electricity, right? I will construct a bridge. I will construct the highways, the road, rural development and all that. This is that basically plan. But suddenly one natural calamity happened and all this area got demolished. Now I need to reconstruct it, right? So at that time, this is non-plan. So it is within the scope of government plans. It is out of scope. It shows expenditure to be incurred or the project covered under central plans. It shows expenditure to be incurred on project not covered under the central plan. Example, expenditure on electricity generation, rural development, road, bridge, etc. And expenditure on relief to the earthquake victims, construction of houses demolished due to floods, etc. Clear?
Yes,
ma'am.
मैम।
Okay, so now what we people are going to do, we are going to do the numerical part, like not going to do this. I'll just ask you to write down the formula. Okay. Okay. So now budget deficit, ma'am, what is this budget deficit? So budget deficit is nothing. It's basically, for example, let's just take an example. You went to, like it's your birthday, right? It's your birthday. So you are planning that, okay, this is like, I'll go there, over there, everything. So your total budget was 500 rupees. Okay. You plan that for 100 rupees, you will bring the cake and 200 rupees pizza and like 100 rupees snacks and all that, then 100 rupees folding and all. This was your budget. Okay, but now when you had everything over here, your the total bill which came was for 600 rupees, right? So over here, the your budget was 500 rupees and now this the bill is 600 rupees. Of course, you have to pay 600 rupees to them, right? Now the problem which comes to you is that 500 and 600, the problem is that, ma'am, okay, if you will subtract it, like this 100 rupees extra, what you will do, either you will purchase, you will borrow it from your friend, or you will take it from, you know, your relatives or your mother and father from there, right? So this 100 rupees, right, is basically the deficit. Clear? Got the point? Yes?
Can you explain once?
Okay. A deficit is basically whatever your budget is and how much extra you are spending, right? So over here, your budget for birthday party was 500. But how much you spend it? You spend it 600 rupees, right? So the budget was this. So whatever more amount of money you are spending, the 100 rupees more you spend it, this is your BD, which is budget deficit. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So when, see, over here, budget deficit is defined as the excess of total estimated expenditure. You estimated that you will spend 500 rupees, but this is excess. Now it is 600, right? Over the total estimated revenue. Right? You got 500 rupees, but your expenditure was 600 rupees, right? So when the government expenditure exceeds its revenue, like government is planning the entire 2023, government is planning that they will get 100 rupees and they will do expenditure of 80 rupees. But unfortunately, government expenditure was for 500 rupees and their revenue was only for 200 rupees.